came that Stompie has passed on. And the news had to be relayed. The secretary had to relate the news to the entire caucus of 121 comrades. It was not an easy task. It was one of the most difficult tasks to do on that day, to share the news with the comrades. And the atmosphere completely changed in the room. Men and women could not hold themselves. There were tears and cries throughout. But we had to go back and fight the battle in council. And we said we will go back and nominate and vote for a mayoral candidate, because Stompie would have wanted us to do exactly that. And we did go back, program director. I must also share with you at the point when she was not feeling well, when the paramedics arrived, she was refusing to leave. And she said, I will not leave, I must vote first. She grabbed Comrade Justice and said, I am not going, I must vote. Comrade Nontlantlam Thembu is among the great galaxy of leaders of our people who had given their all to ensure that all our people were liberated from oppression, from poverty and underdevelopment, and the intolerable pain of contempt, of humiliation, of apartheid. She lived and died as an unwavering soldier of humanism, a combatant for a justice cause, a cause to rid her society, country and the world of greed, racism and oppression, by a minority whose sole claim to this despicable conduct was the pigmentation of their skin. She dedicated her entire life to ensure that the only home for the poor, the African National Congress, a movement of the people, remained on course to delivering on its calling. When on a daylight, youngsters she taught to speak, whose very hands and short, they were fed, clothed and washed, colluded with sellouts and soulless individuals whose only justification is rent and dollar reward. Velase called upon the ancestors. She asked the great kings Ushaka, Uqetshwayo, Usikhukhuni, Udingane to pave way for her soul. Many in this world may not know who is Comrade Stompie is. You might have encountered her. You might have encountered this gentle giant. And because of her humility, you would not have known the role she played in the struggle for national liberation. Her humanism made her to be. Those who knew her, they will tell you that Comrade Stompie belonged to a special breed of the representatives of our people. She belonged among those through the generations who are the best representatives of the recognized nobility of the masses of our people, the representatives who decided that their lives were worth nothing unless they dedicated those lives to the service of all our people. She was amongst those comrades that Comrade Thabo Mbeki describes as, I quote, those who embarked on the long march at the head of the combat columns of liberators, having conquered the fear of what might happen to them at the hands of the oppressors of their people, ready to pay any price for the recovery of the dignity of the harsh conditions of the earth, close quote. Comrades, let me also confirm that on Monday, Johannesburg was literally taken back to 1652. A minority regime in a familiar apartheid style with stooges and puppets, and sellout was installed in an unholy alliance. That is the tragedy that claimed the life of Comrade Stompie. Let me assure you, in the same vein, that we have never been more prepared to serve our people. We are not battle scared. We are committed and well equipped, just like Comrade Stompie would have expected us to carry the battle forward for our people. The temporary Herman Mayer, hair in the sense of hair, should make sure that these masters will now have to come out clean, as we will be going deeper to our roots. The mass character of our movement will be realized now on how deep amongst our people we are. Comrade Stompie departed like a true soldier with a boots on. But even more significantly, she left us a very special, she left on a very special month. A month when we are celebrating our women folk, the mothers of our nation. She being a sterile example of such. She got her marching orders from leaders of 1956. They want stradom, I quote, "Stradom, you have tampered with the women, you have struck a rock," close quote. They then dispersed quietly in dignity, conscious that they had made history. It seems like the grandchildren of stradom did not hear the warning. They have gone back to Tswane and Johannesburg with puppets in front. Let them be warned, they have struck a rock. Comrades, allow me to use this moment, as Comrade Stompie would have loved us to do. I call upon all dedicated members of our movement to go back to basics. Let us, in her honor and memory, go back to basics and be driven by a strong, abiding love for justice, a sense of human solidarity, a genuine empathy, and a concern for the suffering of others, more especially the poor people. Let us translate into action Comrade Stompie's deeply felt desire for justice. To combat and defeat injustice, we must take up the struggle to confront the forces of evil and manipulation which oppress and exploit fellow South Africans today. Program Director, as we're sitting in council on Monday, we were disrespected. We were insulted. Comrade Tambo would have taught us that once the enemy is advancing, we must not retreat, but we must be on the offensive. Short as I am, I went to the stage, lost my temper in defense of the revolution. And I said, we cannot sit and fold arms when democracy is being compromised. A secret vote is a secret vote. A secret ballot must be maintained as a secret ballot. And I was ready. I went to the giant and I said, I am ready to fight. Now, Comrade Mokgasi was so shocked that the short man has the ability to confront a giant. But I suppose we were trained by the African National Congress. Today, more than ever before, we need young people of courage to fight racism and oppression in Johannesburg. We need young people who are ready to endure hardships and make personal sacrifices to make South Africa a better country to live in.